particular book is a thriller, it's a fiction. I won't say much about it. It has drugs, drama, lust. I hope you all buy a copy, enjoy the book and read it. We have three extraordinary men here on the panel today. So you all know them, but I'll still very briefly introduce them. Hussain Zaidi is the number one crime writer in the country. At Penguin Random House India, we publish an imprint with him, which is called Blue Salt, and you can see Blue Salt all over here, where we try and curate a list of fiction and non-fiction, cutting edge. And we're very lucky to have Hussain mentor a lot of young writers from across the country. So thank you so much, Hussain, for doing this and leading Blue Salt. He's written several books. You know, everybody's heard of Black Friday, Don't Rush to Buy, Abu Salem, Dangerous Minds, and currently he's working on his new book, which I hope to publish soon, tentatively titled Mentor, which is about Daud Ibrahim's mentor Khalid, who was a wrestler. That's a little like sneak peek into Hussain's next work. Babu Durrani is a leading actor. We all are fans. I think there's nobody who does comedy as well as he does. I'm taking the liberty to say that. I'm a big fan. But he's done several films. I think there are actors we go to watch just because, not only because of, you know, big stars, but because of the characters that they're playing. He makes them come alive. And we're very lucky to have him here this evening to launch the book. Bilal, I've already spoken about. I'd just like to add that I think, what can I say? There's so many. I keep on talking about him. We did a wonderful conversation very recently on Bookish, you know, which is available online, and which where we talked about his writing process and so many other things. He's very, what I like about him the most is that he's very sincere, extremely hardworking. I know if I want to pester him at 2 a.m., he'll be up and working. So, it's brilliant the way he works. Three jobs that he handles with the humility and sincerity. So thank you so much, Bilal, for being you, and congratulations to you on the new book. I would now request Babu Durrani to say a few words and then launch the book.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for being here. So beautiful to see the support, especially for writers. Bilal has been a friend of mine for the last 2 years, maybe even more. And he's studying in Bombay Scottish School at the moment. And I think Penguin has done a disservice, actually, because there is such a thing, the man, called child labor. And you're absolutely guilty, but since we are doing it nice and quiet and nobody knows that we don't put Bilal's young age on the book, it's fine. But everybody over here knows Bilal, I hope, and you will know more of him, because I do believe, and I say this with great sincerity, not because I'm standing here with the stage, on the stage with a mic, that you'll be hearing more and more of him, not here only in the city and across the country, but even across the world. I first came across this name, Bilal, and I heard that this young man, that at the time he was what, 12? Okay, we'll flip it around, 21. He was 21, am I right? When you wrote Bar of Blood. And I heard that this 21-year-old writer has written this thriller, which is very edgy and with the right support and the right mentoring, I can't tell you how important it is. And then I just tweeted about it. I just tweeted about it and I said that I think, not that I was being patronizing, but I think it's important to encourage youngsters in whatever they do. Like y'all encourage me as a youngster in whatever I do. So that's when I met him. And then I started writing a script, which has been taken forever. And I called Bilal over and asked him if he could assist me and help me with the script. And we spent many a wonderful night, much to his mother's chagrin. She calls at 2 in the morning. That's the time he actually wakes up. That's not the time he's awake. And she says, when are you coming home? And say, I'm sitting with Baman. Who is Baman? I could hear because he used to put in the speaker and say, see, my mom. Who is this Baman? I'm joking. She just, like all good moms, want to know that he goes home safe and that he's in safe hands. And I can say this with great sincerity. When he was with me, he was not in safe hands. But I'll tell you today, I think he's in safe hands simply because he has all of your support. And I would really, really like it that the art of writing is encouraged, not just for people of his age, but for all of us. From the young to the old. And I think it's very important today, even in cinema. I just feel that on a movie poster, you see the faces of the stars, and that's great, and that's what sells tickets. But when it comes to credit, I feel extremely saddened that the credit of a writer, sometimes it's non-existent. It's a lyricist, it's a music director, it's a choreographer, but it never is the writer. Francis Ford Coppola's magnum opus, The Godfather, Francis Ford Coppola put on the poster, instead of his name, Mario Puzo. Mario Puzo's Godfather. He acknowledged the presence and the importance of a writer. I tell you something, and I'm speaking simply as a cinema man, that with a bad director can make a decent script, a decent movie out of a good script, or even ruin it to a certain extent. But he'll still make a good movie with a good script. But with a bad script, no director can do nothing. He'll make a terrible film. So I think it's very, very important that we, our writers in this country, people like him, people like all of us, need to be acknowledged. And I'm going to be a little stern over here. Paid well. And I think that's important because Bilal has such wonderfully encouraging parents and a family. All young, talented writers do not have that backing. They don't. Because if they're not paid well, they have responsibilities, and if their parents say, no, you've got to work and take a proper job, they will give up their dream of being another Bilal. You know what I'm saying. So I'd like to acknowledge the parents, Bilal's parents, for doing what they do. It's so important. And that's why we have a Bilal. And that's why we have Bilal. So I've taken up enough of your time. Normally I speak at least 45 minutes today. I'm sparing you all in 7. Thank you so much. Please give this man a round of applause. Excellent time to do so. Round of applause if you have everybody. Stand up for somebody standing for you. Yeah, you're a school boy. Yeah. Give me a hug.
Don't say we, sir, please.
I'm joking.
Ready? Wake up, catch up. Yeah.
Mobile, turn down. Turn down, please. Mobile, Nicho. Wait, sir, look here.
Hey, better, hey, hello.
Now request Hussain is ready to initiate the panel discussion.
Sorry.
Discussion?
It is going to be a proper discussion. We talk after the
Actually, it's a very emotional moment when you see your child, your family doing so well. And I'm really firmly for words here to express what I'm feeling for Mr. Bilal Siddiqui, who I happen to know for 5 years now. When he came to meet me, he was only 18. And he wrote his first book when he was 19. So imagine the 5 year of journey with him, seeing him growing from strength to strength would be a very, very emotional moment. I understand you all are fans and you understand what I mean when you see a child growing. Bilal has very few bad habits. I want to cover bad habits today. Mr. Ghani has praised him so much. Billy has praised him so much. He's very, very zippy. He does not listen. I want him to sleep at night and he's writing at night. I mean, what can I say? I mean, I want to say that, boss, you can take more time to write a book, you can take a year to write, he finishes in 3 months. So, I mean, these are some of the very, very bad habits which I don't like.
It's a very good habit, you know, ask a publisher also.
See, you'll be very commercially driven.
Chai paper.
So, there are times I give you an assignment that you can take 1 week to finish it and he finishes in 1 night. I really don't like these bad habits. For the simple reason that the man is making me insecure. He's going to make me outdated very soon. And this is going to drive me nuts. Well, I've been a journalist for 20 years, so I will speak my journalistic language. In journalism, you are known by your last byline. And Mr. Siddiqui has written 2 fantastic books before this one. He has written Bard of Blood. It's a very, very unique and very, very extraordinary story. You all should read it. And it was so unique that Red Chillies of Mr. Shah Rukh Khan decided to make his debut production on Netflix. It's going to be a Just imagine how fantastic that book would be. So you all should read it, pick up a copy before you start reading Stars to Fair. The best thing about that book is that one of the reviews was that people thought that it's been written by a retired IP agent. Someone who has put in 40 years of service and after that he written his experiences. So he was astonished to know that it was written by a 19 year old then. And his second book after that was a non-fiction with Imran Hashmi. We all know Kiss of Life. It's again a very super, very touching, poignant book about a child's struggle against cancer. His third book is a book which I wanted to write in, say, a couple years from now about a starlet marrying a very, very notorious drug lord, international drug baron. And the story which people are still unfolding, Mumbai police and Thane police are still unraveling that story, which Bilal has encapsulated in a fictionalized format here. It's a page-turning thriller. I'm sure you guys are going to read it and enjoy it and understand what this book is all about. But the finale is really breathtaking. And in fact, there are so many twists and turns that when I keep reading the book, I realize that how come this 22-year-old is so mature to handle the story with this kind of finesse and this kind of felicity. Well, I won't say much and I will now ask you questions to these guys. So Bilal, why do you think to write only about spy genre, crime, action, all those stories? Why not love story? You are such a young guy.
I did write a love story between a father and son, the second book.
No, no, the love story, I mean.
Looking at his mother.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mom, step out and answer. No, yeah. This is a genre I like writing. So. Would you write a love story as well?
No, this is about you, Bilal. Please put down the tables on me. So, why don't you write? I mean, some love story between 2 spies, between 2 agents, and between some RW people loving each other, like Tiger Zinda and Tiger Types.
I don't know, maybe the sequel. Can happen.
Yeah, I don't mind. I think he can try it out.
But you know, we've had discussions while, you know, working on the Cyclops Affair, and we were discussing the plot. And so there is a bit of, you know, there is a relationship between the lead characters. But I think Bilal likes writing fiction. That is his style. And I think a writer should be true to, you know, what they want to do. It is his way of expressing and telling a story. So he likes fast-paced action. He likes drama, you know. He needs some of those elements to tell the story.
How do you research your books, by when you work on them?
I call you up, sir.
You're supposed to say nice things. How do you do research?
No, apart from the usual, like reading and watching documentaries and looking at subject matter online, you have been a great resource in that sense, because you open doors to me that I don't think I'd have managed to get from it as a resource in any box or even the intelligence ages who were never read as spoken about. So I think a lot of that credit goes to in terms of making sure the research of all of my fiction books are.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bhavansar, what do you think about him, his writing skills and his storytelling techniques when you write in a script like him?
While I was working with him, we were having these sessions, he doesn't go for the ordinary. He always thinks of something that someone else may not have thought of. So even if it is an idea that may not work, he puts it out. He'll always say, it's not a great idea, it's a bad idea, but it's different. And invariably, that different idea, which he says is a bad idea, is the good idea. Because it's simply good because nobody else thought of it. It's simply good simply because he doesn't want to go down that path that everybody expects the story to go down. Wants to do something different. Sometimes the ideas are not good, and I'm not saying in a bad way. I think the greatest of writers come up with some really, really bad ideas, and out of those bad ideas and the worst idea probably comes the best idea. So he likes to do the things that the reader might feel, yeah, ye kahani yahan jaani chahiye. He chooses the other path, and I really, really appreciate that. Apart from that, he's sincere. I mean, if he's saying nice things, you might as well lie all the way. He's sincere, he lands up, and it's so strange, you know. There's another thing that we bond a lot over, and it's strange. Look at his size, but he loves food. And so do I. So he's always packing something and bringing home. But that shows his enthusiasm, that he's not coming just there just to sit and do a session, but it's also a conversation about life. And unless writers and people who create talk about life in general, they can't do anything. You've got to know about humanity, you've got to know about your friends, you've got to talk about your parents, you've got to talk about relationships. He never tells me about relationships. There are no relationships. Tell his father not to worry, trust me. He would have told me by now, and I would have had to. Have you told them about her or not? Oh, one. So this is what I like about Bilal, the way that he chooses a path that has not been trodden before.
So Bilal, can you just give us a gist about the story, Stardust Affair? What is it about?
It's about a journalist who steps into this world of this actress who is now a fading actress and is married to a drug lord. And it's about how he gets involved in this particular world and dragged into it in a way, and it's up to him to kind of unsolve the crime that has been committed. It's more in the pulp fiction thriller zone. It's not like a spy thriller, but it's a lot to do with the plays between emotions of the two characters.
Bhavansar, what is that script that you're doing with him? Is it a thriller? Is it a love story?
It's not a thriller, and you can't.
Just a genre. We don't want to know the story. We don't want to know the story.
But it does answer your first question, sir. I mean, it's not a thriller, it's not spy, it's not action. It's an emotional drama. It's a real fun.
We're just trying to say how versatile he is. Just now, we just made a point. You see how simply the man is boasted about his fantastic book.
That's a story.
So, what are the drawbacks and negative points? Can you please highlight? No, she will try to put some here. This is what we do.
Honestly, I really don't know what his drawbacks are. I'm sure there are many, but he's hidden them for me, for sure. And if there were drawbacks, trust me, I would have told you. I really would have told you. His sleeping hours, you're right. His sleeping time is terrible. Absolutely terrible. What time do you wake up every morning? Say it, the mommy knows.
Wake up in the morning or afternoon?
Well, that's good. That's his world. He's created a world for himself. Right. And sometimes I feel that maybe when you get to Sir's age, it may not be a good idea.
Right. So, Bilal, what's your next book about? Editing stories, how good or how mature they are. Look at his age, his eye level.
Well, I don't think that he's growing with each book. So, you know, the first book was very different from the second that he wrote with Imran, which was more emotional and mature and non-fiction. The third one is also very different. So I think he's growing with each book. And I'm, I wait for Bilal to call me and discuss the plot, because most of the time I am surprised he comes up with something new. So I do see a sort of a growth in him as a writer. I think he has many, many books in him. And I don't think he's one of those writers...
Bilal, sit down.
Right.
Sorry.
There we go. So yes, so we have another Bilal in the making here, right here in the bookstore. But yes, I think he has that unique quality. I think that he can write all kinds of books and he should not limit himself. And that's how I view him also as a writer.
So you'd like to ask something about it?
I'll say something generally, that Bilal is on the cusp of being a wonderful asset to our country. He's on the cusp of being, making a name. But these times, and I think you come into the picture here as you sort of making sure that, yes, we'd like Bilal to be prolific and come out book after book after book. But the first book, for example, he took his time. I think he took a reasonable amount, and he should just take time. I don't think that in this age where everything has to be moving fast, we put pressure on the man so that he becomes prolific. Because being prolific is very different from being inventive. And it can take as much time as you like, Bilal. Because you know what? You know what your secret is? You've got time and age on your side. So don't run the rat race. I'm sorry, I'm preaching over you, but don't run the rat race. Take your time. You do not have to meet the deadlines. You do not have to meet the deadlines.
No,
I'm not directing this at you. I'm genuinely saying.
No, I'm also saying this in a nice way. I agree with you.
Yeah.
In fact,
because what happens is then you say, oh, my next book has to be out by so and so. No. You take your time, mull over it, sleep over it, let it percolate in your brain, enjoy the process, and then put it out. The easy part is when you're on the typewriter. The difficult part is when you're sitting and thinking, right? So take your time to think, Bilal. We're all with you. We're all with you.
Very beautifully put. I'd just like to add that I totally agree with you. In fact, we don't have any date, any deadline for Bilal. I just want to say that I agree with you, and I think creativity comes on its own and takes its own time. And this is the truth with Bilal. We haven't.
Did you
asked
notice
him
that
for
I
his
am
next.
Typewriter?
Well, now I know.
Typewriter.
I I'm old, okay, I'm old.
Now I know.
I can do better, dig at my age. I use a typewriter. I still use a typewriter. I'm pretty proud of it. My grandfather's typewriter. He was maybe a dig at my age, I know. My first pet was not a dog, it was a baby dinosaur. I know.
So, you should ask me.
Yeah, if you have any questions, please put your hands up and we'll circle with mine.
Good evening. I'm Apurva Parik. First of all, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
And you have a book launch in the presence of the titan of our industry, Lagero Munna Bhai MBS. Let me tell you, this is your proudest day in your life. It's a red letter. Now, question. I wanted to ask about the publisher of Penguin, such a young boy. What talent do you see in him that not one book, two books, three books, four books? That is my one question. So, for a publisher like Penguin, what do you see in a writer that you associate that? That is one question. Second question, Bilal. I just, about his book and all, I came to know. But what in your family background that inculcated in you, Sachin Tendulkar's son would like to be a cricketer, wrestlers would like that. What is there in you, in your genes, to write and associate? Writing career doesn't bring much money, unfortunately, with the digital. What took you to this? Three books, four books. Fantastic, I salute you.
Well, I think the proof is in the pudding. He is a good writer, and that is why we picked him. And I think as editors, when we're selecting a manuscript or proposal, we don't think of the age of the writer. So we just go by the proposal, chapters, the writing. And we also, you know, have Puffin, where we're published with 13-year-olds as well. So Bilal does have some competition in the children's NYA segment. And it's just purely on the merit of the book.
I'll answer that. See his dad standing proudly over there? See, he looks like Salman Rushdie. He is Salman Rushdie. What more you want about jeans now? There it is.
So it does come a lot from my dad. He has inculcated the habit of reading at a very early on. A lot of it also comes from home, because when I write, I try to make stuff cinematic, and she was the one who used to take me to the theater at a very, very young age.
She's crying, Bilal. You made her cry today. This was a happy day. She's crying. She's full of tears.
It's good. Yes. Please.
Don't click her crying at this. So, yes, yes. Luckily, there have never been things. I mean, there are no restrictions on me. There have never been restrictions on me, and I'm happy to be born to them, because obviously there is no financial crunch to speak, right, which would discourage me from writing. They've always been encouraging about it. And even more so after the first book got published. Had you rejected the manuscript, that would have been a different story. So yeah, that's about it. So thank you for your
question. I also dabble in writing. I feel good. Fiction is very difficult to write. What characters, what name of the character, what face to say, like Arkenara, like we had Madhuri days, which face. And you should not offend some religion, like, you know, it is many things. So like, how exactly do you move about it?
Sir, thank you very much, sir. Shall I have more questions, sir?
Take it.
Yeah. When we set out to write fiction, it's about, there is research. I like writing fiction, which has a certain element of truth. There is fiction within 9 PM. The characters have to be extremely interesting. Like, I think hopefully these two are the guys. They don't look like that. But anyway. But real problem. In Imran Hashmi's book, of course, there are real life guys and super naturally an easier kind of get what they carry to get as well. Similarly, characters write the story, and because it's fiction, you can build the character the way you want it to go, one story to move forward. Like common sense script that we're doing is it's all about how interesting the two characters are for the songs. It's a really good place, because it's very touching on this one. So yes, no, that's.
Any other questions?
Okay, my question is to Bilal. How do you manage a transition phase? Like, you write books about different genres. So how do you manage it? Like, if you are writing this book now, the ideas from the previous book might have cropped into your mind. So how do you manage it? Means how you sequence it properly?
I think there's a fair gap between the books. There's enough time for me to take off from what the previous story was, and then take some time and decide what I want to do next. So it's only once I leave that story behind do I think of the next one. Actually, it's a very important question even to answer. Because as an actor, I think that's even tougher to perhaps face the way. And then processing your attitude, the result of shooting simultaneously, or generally,
it's just more or less the same. It's just that you have to be involved with the character, but don't fall in love with the character so much that you stop falling in love with yourself. Because eventually you are you. You leave that character at some point and you say, it was a nice journey with you. I inhabited you, but goodbye. Because sometimes what happens when a character is a little more larger than life, you tend to take those thoughts with you into your everyday life. And that is something, as a process, especially in theatre, especially because in a theatrical piece, audiences applaud and audiences, you know, tend to make you feel very high. So when you go into the makeup room, it takes you a lot of time to, even when you change your costume, because you want to live that moment because you're getting a high outside. So a veteran actor, Sudhir Joshi, told me, there's only one solution. There is this cold cream, you put it on your face, wipe your face, remove that makeup and look at yourself in the mirror. It's as simple as that. I mean, it's not as simple as it sounds, but you don't fall in love with the character so much because the character is being applauded. You should want to be yourself at the end of the day.
Any other questions?
Honestly, I would really, I'm sorry I'm stepping out of line here, but I would really like it if Bilal's parents came on stage so we can take a photo.
No, I think that is
they deserve to be here more than, with your permission, more than the...
Please come forward.
So let's say Bilal's got most of that, I think, from the, if any of the fiction shows it, I'm not sure, but sooner or later it will. And I think I'll.
Bilal didn't quite use, and our daughter would do that. All those toys were passed on to her. So she also writes, but she gets influenced by her brother, and she kind of writes, but Bilal helps her a lot in her writing. And I think everything goes hand in hand, you know, the entire group, even Zena, I and Bilal, we kind of work towards getting out of his way when he's working. There are times where it's very taxing for me because I want him to spend time with us, but he doesn't have that kind of time, especially after the part of that working on, you know, converting it into a screenplay. So he's working around 18 hours a day now. So he sleeps late and he wakes up in the afternoon.
Life of a writer is indeed tough. But, you know, thank you so much for supporting him all through the way. I know it's
tough.
We have a question?
Bilal, congratulations.